Hi YouTube! As always, you can call me Lore, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have not one, but two announcements that I'm super excited to share with you, so let's get to it!
We're gonna talk about things and maybe make some things too.
Alright, we're gonna see if I can do this all in one take. I don't think I can, but let's see.
Every year, six lively halfling families reunite during the transition from summer to autumn. This has been a long-loved tradition for generations as they celebrate the turning of the seasons, the health and family of friends, and the glory of bragging rights for their family. It's an all-around showcase of the best of all halflings.
I get to go to Shiretown Shindig! I'm super excited! It's its first inaugural event this year. It's a LARP. It's pretty much Hobbit the LARP. It's so amazing. It is directed by Dan Comstock and produced by Yule Commons and LARP Box. It's going to be happening up in Massachusetts, and man, I am so excited! It's going to have beautiful fall, September-y vibes. Hopefully, I hope it's still not summer, but hopefully. And I'm beyond excited. Shiretown Shindig is actually based on another LARP that came out of Australia called Hobbit's Hoedown, which was created by Destiny Panaraj. And I was looking at, you can see pictures of their events. They've had it for a couple of years. You can see photos of their events. And they have, one of the activities that they have is a maple and... So Shiretown Shindig, while Shire is in the name, and so it sounds like the Shire, like it's from Lord of the Rings or Middle Earth, it's not actually set in the Lord of the Rings universe. It is definitely heavily inspired, but it's actually set in the universe of the LARP Avaris, which is another LARP that's put on by Yule Commons. But much like the Shire in Middle Earth, the hobbits in Avaris, or the world Aerith, are not interested in what's happening in the rest of the world. They care about family tension, they care about who has the biggest pumpkin, they do not care about the next siege on the other side of the world. They could not care less.
What? No, no. No, wait. We do not want any adventures here. Thank you. Not today.
So it is very secluded in the same kind of way. So character creation in Shiretown Shindig is really interesting because it's very, very loosey-goosey. You don't need necessarily a pool for admins, you do create your own character. They gave you a set of like loose guidelines, and we'll talk about them more because I want to kind of go through and introduce you to my character and go through kind of the process that I went through when I created her. But we'll talk about that in another video. The thing I'm most excited for Shiretown Shindig is what I call the five F's of hobbiting: food, friendship, fashion, fun, and frivolity. And now you're gonna say fun and frivolity are the same thing, but I do not agree. There are some things in frivolity that I do not think happen in fun, definitely some shenanigans. So, super excited. Shiretown Shindig feels like the perfect first LARP for me, just to run around, meet new people, and just pretend to be wonderful small beans while enjoying way too much food and living our best pastoral lives. I'm so excited. So the next LARP I'm attending on the opposite end of the spectrum is called The Haunting of Grey Manor. The Haunting of Grey Manor is another LARP. It's being put on by Reverie Studios, and it is also happening up in Massachusetts, so I'm going to be back and forth to Massachusetts in the fall. It's going to be something. But the premise of The Haunting of Grey Manor is Grey Manor is this paranormal hotspot. It's this mysterious and wonderful house where everybody in the paranormal community is just like, it is the place to be. And occasionally invitations are sent out for people to come and visit the house. So we are playing guests that have been invited to said paranormal house by very mysterious owner that I don't know if we know who it is or if we actually get to meet them, but we've been invited to the house by this person we may or may not know, just to, you know, explore it. Nothing could possibly go wrong. It's fun. So it's going to be, I think, kind of like this dinner party theme where we get to explore the house and things are going to happen. Including us potentially not making it out of the house. The LARP is interested in exploring a lot of really kind of deep and maybe esoteric themes.
Hi, hello, how are you? This is an older and wiser lore from the future who has access to the Google machine and a dictionary. So I said esoteric there, and what I really meant was existential. While esoteric isn't incorrect, it is absolutely not what I meant. I never pretend to be smart. Cool. Back to the video.
LARP is interested in exploring a lot of really kind of deep and maybe
existential
themes of kind of death and what that means, and I do believe there's going to be a section where we get to play our characters and then play our characters as ghosts. So that's going to be really, really interesting. One thing that's important to know, because I mean, I'm new, you don't know me very well, but I am a baby. I do not do scary things. I do not watch horror movies. I don't do haunted mansions or haunted like trail thing. I don't know. I don't do scary, really. Because I like to think that I have an overactive imagination and that my brain likes to latch on to scary things and make me think about them and relive them for the next week, not causing me not to get sleep. So, I am excited for this LARP. I'm like a little worried, but I want to push myself out of the comfort zone, kind of see what the storytelling will be like. It's been such an amazing process so far. The character creation for this was more like those bigger blockbuster style LARPs where writers are creating your character for you. You fill out this really comprehensive form that gives them an idea of things you're comfortable playing, things you're not comfortable playing, organizations you might want to be part of, and kind of things you like and don't like. And they take all that, they synthesize it into a character. They've given us our blurbs for our character, and they're still working, but I think very, very soon we're going to have our full characters out. And I got my blurb for my character, and I read it, and I was just like, I feel like you wrote me on paper playing up a single insecurity without knowing me, and I'm not sure how you did that. I'm a little worried, but it will be interesting. She's very, I don't want to say she's similar to me, but I definitely see the similarities and the things, and we'll do a video where you get to meet her, and I'll do the kind of the same thing with Shia Tanchin, Nick, probably where we choose her costuming, because that, for one, I have not done yet, so maybe they'll be happening as I do it, which will be pretty cool. But definitely excited to very, very different style, or two very different ends of the spectrum. But I'm excited to see what the experience is like, and I'm excited to kind of tell you about the experience, and hope you're excited too. So thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, consider subscribing or liking or commenting or just saying hey, and get ready for the next video. All right, bye.